In today's video, I will tell you how to trace faults in an air conditioner if it develops any issues. Many viewers have asked me where to start fault tracing and testing in an air conditioner. There are certain situations to consider, and you have to work according to those situations. This is my line of work, and I have gained considerable experience in this field. I know exactly where to begin, so let me share this with you as well. If there's a fault in the indoor or outdoor unit, I've observed that most people, even professionals, try to look for a major fault and assume that something big has gone wrong. However, I always start testing the unit by focusing on smaller faults. A major fault in the unit is usually apparent and visible, but a small fault is not easy to detect. You have to search for it. Therefore, always prepare your mind to look for smaller faults first. This way, you will be able to find the fault more easily. The first situation, which often occurs, is something I'll explain to you now. An air conditioner is mounted on the wall. In this situation, the unit is not working at all. Even when we turn on the electric socket switch, the unit doesn't operate. For this, there is no need to directly open the unit. The first step is to check its power supply to see if electricity is present or not. So, where does the electricity come from? Electricity either comes from the MCB, miniature circuit breaker, the main power supply board, or from the socket itself. I will unplug the power plug from the socket and check whether there is electricity flowing through it, specifically whether 220 AC volts are present in it. Now, I will remove the plug from the socket. Next, I will check the power supply in the socket using a multimeter to measure the voltage. The socket is showing 240 AC volts. Now that we've confirmed the voltage, the next step is to check the wire connected to it to ensure it hasn't burned out. We also need to verify whether electricity is reaching the unit's connectors or not. Now, we will lift the unit's hood, and underneath this cover, we'll find the connectors. Below this panel, there is a PCB board. Here, we will inspect what components could potentially be faulty. I have another unit available here, and its indoor cover has already been removed. Connectors have different designs in different units. On this connector, you'll see markings like 1, N, and L. We need to check for power at the L and N terminals, where there should be 220 AC volts. If electricity is present at this connector, it means the fault lies in the indoor air conditioner's circuit board. Even with the PCB, we will first focus on identifying smaller faults before moving to anything major. Here, I have a circuit board from an indoor unit. In most indoor units, the situation is usually similar. There might be slight differences, but generally it's the same. On this circuit, there's a 3.15 amp fuse. If this fuse blows, the PCB board won't power on at all. However, there's also a situation where safety protections are built into the board. For instance, there's a ZNR, zinc oxide varistor, installed here, which is voltage dependent. It's designed to handle voltages and can withstand up to a maximum of 250 volts. If there's a higher voltage fluctuation, this component will short circuit. If the voltage exceeds its capacity significantly, it may burn out completely. When the ZNR short circuits, it often causes the fuse to blow as well. Therefore, inspect the circuit to check if the ZNR is burned out. If it is, you can easily repair the circuit. If both the fuse and the ZNR are fine, then the next possibility is that something else on the circuit board might be faulty. Most of the time, issues arise in the high side section of the circuit. Here, you can see the switching IC on this circuit board, which appears to be burnt from the top. It's partially damaged from the upper side. This indicates that the switching IC is faulty, and there is likely an issue with the SMPS switch mode power supply as well. In this case, the SMPS will need to be repaired. Let me share another method for checking electricity. If you don't have a multimeter, a simple tester can also work for you. Using a tester, you can check electricity. When I place the tester on the line terminal, it glows, indicating a live connection. However, it doesn't glow on the neutral terminal. With a tester, you can only verify the presence of a live connection. To confirm whether the neutral connection is present or not, you will need a multimeter. Only then can you be sure about the neutral wire. Now, let's move to the next situation. The indoor unit is functioning, but it's not cooling despite running. Most modern air conditioners have built-in error codes for diagnostics. For instance, on this unit, an error code suddenly appeared, showing E0. This is just a demo to explain. An E0 error could indicate a problem in the indoor unit, the outdoor unit, or both. To address this, you first need to understand the meaning of the E0 error. We've uploaded several videos on our channel about error codes for specific air conditioner brands, and we'll continue adding more. For any error code, you must investigate the specific area the code points to, diagnose the issue, and then fix it accordingly. In another situation, the indoor unit might be running and displaying an error code, but there's still no cooling. If the error is related to the outdoor unit, then you'll need to check the outdoor unit to see whether it's receiving a proper power supply or not. There can be two possible situations in this case. First, if the supply to the outdoor unit comes from the indoor unit, you need to check the indoor unit first. Another condition could be that the supply goes directly to the outdoor unit. In such cases, the main supply first connects to the outdoor unit circuit board at terminals L and N, and then continues to terminals 1, 2, and 3, connecting the outdoor and indoor units. If your system follows this setup, you'll need to inspect the outdoor unit's circuit board directly to see if it is faulty. Before checking the unit, it's crucial to inspect the wire. If the wire is cut or burnt at any point, the unit may not function. This depends on the specific error code being displayed, and you'll need to work accordingly. Now let me explain another situation related to the outdoor unit. Outdoor units, particularly in inverter air conditioners, rely on the circuit board to function. Most faults in these units are due to components like the fuse or the ZNR becoming damaged. If these components are faulty, the unit can often be repaired quickly. If the PCB is functioning properly, but the unit still doesn't work, there's another factor many people overlook. Outdoor units also have error codes. These error codes are indicated by the blinking of LED lights. By observing the blinking pattern of these lights, you can identify the issue with the outdoor unit. This also helps you determine whether the indoor problem is connected to the outdoor unit. Simply count the blinks to understand the error and diagnose the fault in the unit. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.